Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, the gospel that you received and which you are firmly established. Because the gospel will save you only if you keep believing exactly what I preached to you. Believing anything else will not lead you to anything. Well then, in the first place, I taught you what I have been taught myself, namely that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scriptures, that he was buried, and that he was raised to life on the third day in accordance with the scriptures, that he appeared first to Cephas and secondly to the 12. Next he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers at the same time, most of whom are still alive, though some have died. Then he appeared to James and then to all the apostles. And last of all, he appeared to me too. It was as though I was born and no one expected it. I am the least of the apostles. In fact, since I persecuted the Church of God, I hardly deserve the name apostle. But by God's grace, that is what I am. And the grace that he gave me is that I preach what they preach, and this is what people will believe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. Let the sons of Israel say, his love has no end.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. I shall not die, I shall live in the conscious deeds.
Give thanks to the Lord.
You are my God, I thank you. My God, I praise you. I will thank you, for you have given answer, and you are my Savior.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah. God in Christ was reconciling the world to himself, and he has entrusted to us the news that they are reconciled. Hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
One of the Pharisees invited Jesus to a meal. When he arrived at the Pharisee's house and took his place at the table, a woman came in who had about an ailment in time. She had very good time with the Pharisee and was brought with her an alabaster jar of ointment. She waited behind him at his feet, weeping, and her tears fell on his feet, and she wiped them away with her hair. Then she covered his feet with kisses and anointed them with the ointment. When the Pharisee who invited him saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would know who this woman is who is touching him, and what a bad name she has. Then Jesus took him up and said, Simon, I have something to say to you. Speak, Master, was the reply. There was once a creditor who had two men in his debt, one owed him 500 denarii, the other 50. They were unable to pay, so he pardoned them both. Which of them will love him more? The one who was pardoned more, I suppose, out of time. Jesus said, you are right. Then he turned to the woman. Simon, he said, you see this woman? I came into your house and you poured no water over my feet. But she has poured out her tears over my feet and wiped them away with her hair. You gave me no kiss, but she has been covering my feet with kisses ever since I came in. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she has anointed my feet with oil. For this reason, I tell you that her sins, her many sins, must have been forgiven her, or she would not have shown such great love. It is the man who has forgiven little who shows little love. Then he said to her, your sins are forgiven. Those who were with him at the table began to say to themselves, who is this man that he even forgives sins? But he said to the woman, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
what each has offered to the honour of your name may serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Holy Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Time when he prayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And the Lord of the Church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Rosemary, whom you called from this world to yourself. For on the sheep who was united with your Son in the death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Michael and all the saints who have pleased us throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the same command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed
be thy name, thy kingdom come,
thy
will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of
and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom,
the power, and the glory of yours,
now
and
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign. Lamb of God. Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desire may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today is Vera's 60th wedding anniversary, the diamond wedding anniversary, so we congratulate her today. She said she had a telegram from the Queen this morning, which was wonderful. Vera and Ryan will be at Mass on Sunday. We offer Sunday's Mass for them. We congratulate her today and her birthday yesterday. So all these celebrations at once. Mass, say, Sunday morning, 10 o'clock. Next Thursday is the Feast of Our Lady of Walsingham. Mass again at 12. And then every day we live stream. The Lord be with you.